Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss a central regulatory authority of drug, that is a central drug standard control organization. Learning objectives. Student should able to understand CDSCO, then what is vision mission of this CDSCO, then working strategies, organization structure, then responsibilities and functions of CDSCO. Central Drug Standard and Control Organization is the main regulatory body of India for regulation of pharmaceutical, medical devices and clinical trials. So basically this central authority or central regulatory body is regulating upcoming drugs into the pharmaceutical market, then medical devices, and it is also responsible to give a permission for this clinical trials for new drugs. Then CDSCO is a central drug authority. For discharging function assigned to the central government under the Drug and Cosmetic Act, or functioning under the control and Directorate General of Health Services, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Under the Drugs and Cosmetic Acts, the CDSCO is responsible for approval of drugs, conduct of clinical trial and laying down standards for drug, then control over quality of imported drug into the country. And further, this CDSCO along with state regulation jointly responsible for granting a license of certain specialized categories of critical drugs like blood and blood products, then IV fluids, vaccines and sera. Its headquarters is located in FDA Bhavan, Kolta Road, New Delhi. This is official website of Central Drug Standard Control Organization. Then we'll see vision and mission of this regulatory body. To protect and promote public health in India. How it protect and promote public health? Drug approval process is critically evaluated by this committee or this regulatory body. That's why safe and efficacious drugs are entering into the market. So it helpful to protect the public health, as well as because of such a good quality drug, it helpful to improve the public health. Then mission behind its CDSCO, to safeguard and enhance public health by assuring the safety, efficacy and quality of drugs, cosmetics and medical devices. Then working strategies of this central authority, to achieve a mission and mandate of CDSCO, we will strive to act with transparency, accountability, then punctuality, courtesy, openness, then responsiveness, then professionalism, then impartiality, consistency, integrity and truthfulness. So these are different strategies of this central authority, and it is working according to this strategy. Hierarchy of this CDSCO. Indian government is there at a top position, then Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Drug Controller General of India, then underlying officer will be Joint Drug Controller, then deputy drug controller, then assistant drug controller, director administration, deputy director and section officers. So this is a hierarchy of different officers. Then we'll discuss organization chart. In organization of CDSCO, headquarters is there located into the Delhi. Then zonal offices are present in India. 6 zonal offices are there. Then sub zonal offices, both the zonal and sub zonal offices responsible for this GMP audit, for manufacturing plant, for inspection of this plant, then coordination with states. They are maintaining a coordination with this state authority and conducting these different audits. Then airport and portal offices, a total 9 offices are there, and they are responsible to permit import and export of drug into the India. Then 7 laboratories are present. These laboratory helpful to testing of drug samples and validation of test protocol. Then zonal offices involved into the GMP audit and inspection of manufacturing units of LVPs, sera, vaccine and blood products. These zonal offices are present in Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Ghaziabad and Ahmedabad and Hyderabad. Then sub-zonal offices, this center coordination with state drug control authority under their jurisdiction for uniform standard of inspection. These sub-zonal offices present into Bangalore, Varanasi, Goa, Jammu, Indore, Guwahati and Badli. Then port or airport offices present in India, Delhi, Chennai, Hyderabad, then Indore port, Kolkata port, Mumbai port, Cochin port, Vishakhapattanam sea port and Krishnapattanam sea ports. So these are the different ports where import and export is regulated. Then we'll see different laboratories present in India. Central Drug Laboratory present in Kolkata, then Central Drug Laboratory present in Kasauli, then Central Drug Testing Laboratory present in Mumbai, Central Drug Testing Laboratory in Hyderabad, then Central Drug Testing Laboratory in Chennai, then Regional Drug Testing Laboratory are present into Chandigarh and Guwahati. So these are the different laboratories present in India. As per geographical region, the CDSCO classify the different or divide a part of India into the different zone, that is north zone, west zone, south zone and east zone. Then zonal offices are located at a different places for these different zones. So north zone office is present in Ghaziabad, then west zone office is present into Mumbai, while south zone office is present into Chennai and east zone office is present into Kolkata. Dr. Harshvardhan is the Honorable Minister of Health and Family Welfare. Then Drug Controller General of India, Dr. V.G. Somani. Functions of this CDSCO, this is just overview of functions: approval of new drugs and clinical trials, then import registration and licensing, license approving of blood banks, LBPs, vaccines, then rDNA products, then amendment to these drug and cosmetic acts and their rules as per the requirement of these rules. Amendments are there and that amendments are made by this CDSCO. Then banning of drugs and cosmetics in India, then grant of test license, personal license for export of drugs, then testing of new drugs, Now we'll discuss this function in detail. A laying down of standard drugs and cosmetic and diagnostic devices. Then laying down regulatory measures, amendments to the acts and rules to regulate market authorization of new drugs by approving different applications by this investigator and critically evaluated this entering drug into the market. Then regulate clinical research into the India with the help of regulation of clinical trials. To approve licensing to manufacturer certain categories of drugs like blood products, then LVPs, vaccines and serum. Then to regulate standard of imported drugs, testing of drugs by central drug laboratory, then publication of Indian pharmacopoeia. Along with this CDSCO scrutiny of bills and entry of views to ensuring imported drugs comply with the regulation. Since imported drugs should be safe, they should be efficacious, there should not be any substandardness of or substandard level of drugs. So it is maintained by collecting imported sample of drugs, then the sample sent to the central drug laboratory and testing of drugs is there, and then the CDSCO gives approval to this particular manufacturer to use that drug into the India. To check the shipping bills for export, for statistical data and keep a control under the regulation. To ensure that no new drug is imported into country unless its import is permitted. So without permission, not a single drug can import into the India. Rules related with this import of drug, that is 122A and 30AA. To ensure that small quantities of drugs imported for clinical trial or for the personal use are duly permitted under the test licensing or permit a license as a case may be. So if we required a few drugs for the clinical trial or for the personal use, so for that purpose also you have to take a permission from the CDSCO and then that drug will be imported into the India. Then we'll discuss functions of state authority. This state authority is responsible for the licensing of drug manufacturing and sale establishments, then licensing of drug testing laboratories, approval of drug formulation and manufacture, monitoring quality of drugs and cosmetics, then manufactured by respective state units and those marketed in state. Investigation and prosecution in respect of contravention of legal provision. Then administrative actions are taken by the state authority. Then pre and post licensing inspections are conducted by the state authority. Before approval of any manufacturing plant, inspections are conducted, and that inspections are known as pre licensing inspection. And after approving a plant, a certain period of time inspections are conducted by this state regulatory authority, and that inspection is known as post licensing inspection. Then recall of substandard drugs. If substandard drugs are there in a market, that drugs recalled by state authority. Then we'll discuss responsibilities of this CDSCO. This CDSCO is controlled and governed by Directorate General of Health Services, which comes under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Then CDSCO also works in close context with Central Drug Laboratory for perform a quality control tests of imported products or any manufacturer product before approval or after approval of
license to regulate imported drug as an authority, the CDSCO work with DTAB, that is Drug Technical Advisory Body, and the Drug Consultative Committee, while a central drug laboratory undertakes a testing of such drugs. The central authorities are responsible for approval of new drugs, clinical trials in country, then laying down a standards of drugs, control over quality of imported drugs, then coordination of activities of state drug control organization, and providing expert advice with view of bringing about a uniformity in enforcement of Drugs and Cosmetic Act. So uniformly this standardness of drug is maintained along with the coordination of state authority in throughout the India. Then state authorities, on other hand, are connected with regulation of manufacture, sale and distribution of drugs, then licensing of drugs, then testing laboratories, then approving drug formulation for manufacturer, carrying out pre- and post-licensing inspections, and overseeing the manufacturing process for drugs manufactured by respective state unit and those marketed in the states. These authorities are formed under Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and Rules 1945. Then we'll discuss the functions of court offices, which are located at different places responsible for import of drugs and export of drugs in India. So these offices maintenance of statistics regarding import and export of drugs and cosmetics, then coordination with custom authorities, coordination with states, drugs controller and zonal offices for post import checks, then preparation of monthly, quarterly and annual report of this import and export of drug, to draw a sample from import, export and re-import consignments so that imported samples are checked at the port offices whether that imported or exported sample is having a quality good. So the sample is sent towards the central drug laboratory, then central drug laboratory is giving a results, and as per the result of this central drug laboratory, port offices decide that whether the drug can be imported or exported. Then joint responsibilities of CDSCO along with the state licensing authority related with the vaccine sera, blood components, then LVPs, then rDNA products and medical devices. So this is drug approval process by CDSCO. First of all, application sent towards the CDSCO, that application is known as investigation new drug application. So the CDSCO review this application, and this application reviewed by this IND committee of CDSCO, then recommendation of director the directorate of the central or DCGI is there, and then the IND committee review this application sent by this manufacturer toward the CDSCO, then recommendation of Drug Controller General of India, then as per the recommendation there is and decision of this IND committee, drug is approved or IND application is approved, then there is a starting of clinical trials, then after completion of clinical trials one application is sent by the central manufacturer, that application is known as NDA application, and this NDA application is reviewed by this CDSCO and also reviewed by this DCGI, and then your drug license is granted or refused as per the decision of this different committees of CDSCO. If everything is okay, then your drug is then license for the particular drug is granted. If some queries are there, then that query should be cleared by the manufacturer and then approved by the particular then this query, if when these queries are solved, then again application is required to send by that manufacturer to the CDSCO. Again there is a review and then there is a granting of permission. During this process, tier review process is there, means your application is reviewed by three type of the committees. One is subject expert committee, then technical committee, and apex committee, that is a decision of your drug general controller of India. Then February 2013, a three tier review process has been implemented, wherein each clinical trial application is being referred for the review to technical and apex committee. Then clinical trial process, schedule Y of Drug and Cosmetic Acts explain a guideline for the grant of permission for conducting clinical trials in India. The protocol for such trial are examined by Office of DCGI before permission are granted. Then Office of DCGI also give a grant permission for conducting bioequivalence studies. Then registration of clinical trial has been made mandatory with centralized clinical trials. Then drug cosmetic rules are being amended to make a mandatory the registration of clinical research organization. Drug and Cosmetic Act is proposed to be amended to include a separate chapter on clinical trials. Then for cosmetics, for import of cosmetic in India required to be registered for CDSCO by giving a application in form 42 to obtain registration certificate in form 43. Then the manufacturing person or authorized agent can be applicant for the issuance of registration certificate for import of cosmetic into the India. Then license will granted within 6 months, and the following licenses are required for cosmetic products. License on form 32 is issued for manufacturer sale distribution of cosmetics. Then license on form 32 is issued for loan license for manufacture sale distribution of cosmetic, form 31A. Then medical devices, a new guideline were effective from 1st of January in 2018. Then risk-based classification of medical devices are there. These medical devices into four different classes, that is class A, B, C and D. So class A includes low risk devices like thermometers, then tongue depressors. Then class 2 or class B included low moderate risk devices like suction equipment, hypodermic needles. Then class 3 devices include high moderate risk, that is ventilator, bone fixation plates are there, which are used in orthopedic surgery for the joining of bones. Then class D, that is high risk devices like heart valves. This is organogram of medical device division. Then one more thing, that is Sugam online licensing portal. It is a licensing portal present into the CDSCO website. Why it is there? Because of the an online licensing portal of CDSCO to file an application for various services like application submission, processing and grant of permission for quick delivery of services. So the lengthy process of approval should be avoided by using the Sugam online licensing portals. So what are the benefits of this Sugam online licensing portals? Applicant can apply license under import and registration division of CDSCO, then track a status of that application through online mode, then answer back to raised queries of regulatory bodies through this online mode only. Then applicant can also upload essential document for registration, import license and other related activities. So documents also submitted into the online mode. This is a view of this Sugam online portal of CDSCO. Now we'll see which types of license can be applied through this Sugam portals. Registration certificate, form 41 for drugs, then form 41 for medical devices and form 41 for diagnostic kits. Then import license, form 10 for drugs, then for medical devices, then form 10 for diagnostic kits. So this form 10 is for import of license, form 41 is for registration certificate. Then test license for clinical trials, registration certificate for cosmetics. So this type of the applications are or we can file through this Sugam online portal. So this is all about CDSCO. Thank you.